לבנון היא האחראית ולבנון תישא בתוצאות פעולותיה.
نموت إنا خمس أيام عم نموت كل يوم تبهدلنا وتشرشحنا ومش قابلين بكل هالوضع
حطها هيك، خليك هيك، ها هيك هيك.
لك وين صايبينه يا زلمه؟ يحرق ارض وشو مسطين صايرين؟
مش الحين، لا صاب البيت.
نزل نزل،
خلي خليك، صور صور هون، صور هون.
لا نزل نزل.
On the 12th of July 2006, a violent conflict erupted between Israel and neighboring Lebanon. It began when a military unit of Hezbollah, a Shia Muslim group based in Lebanon, crossed the border and ambushed a group of Israeli soldiers. Three of the soldiers were killed and two kidnapped and taken into Lebanon. Israeli troops attempted a rescue of the abducted soldiers but were unsuccessful. Five more were killed in the attempt. Hezbollah is widely supported by Lebanese Muslims. Provides welfare for the poor and is credited with driving Israeli forces out of Lebanon after 18 years of occupation. Leader Hassan Nasrallah said the only way Israel would get its soldiers back would be to trade them for political prisoners held in Israeli jails. Because of the delicate political balance in the country, the Lebanese government did not get involved. Israel took this as support for Hezbollah. The Lebanese people were to pay dearly. Israel bombarded Lebanon from air, land and sea. It mounted an air and naval blockade and a ground invasion of southern Lebanon. In response, Hezbollah launched rockets into northern Israel, an average of 200 a day for the duration of the conflict. Israeli civilians were advised to take to their cellars for safety. One hospital evacuated its patients to the basement. In all, 44 civilians were killed in Israel. But more shocking was the scale of the damage inflicted on the civilian population in Lebanon. A million people were forced to flee their homes.
Men, women, children, everything from this village coming. Look at the fire there from by my village.
In the makeshift shelters, there was little food, water or medicines to treat the sick. Over the course of the war, more than 1,000 Lebanese civilians were killed and 3,000 wounded. A constant tide of refugees flowed north by whatever means they could. Many villages in southern Lebanon were reduced to rubble. Livestock roamed free in ghost towns. Only the sick and elderly remained. Even after the ceasefire, much of southern Lebanon remained uninhabitable, littered with unexploded cluster bombs. The devastation turned the clock back 20 years. A United Nations brokered ceasefire went into effect on the 14th of August 2006, but Lebanon remained vulnerable. Questions were asked about Israel's military strategy, and the only winner appeared to be Hezbollah.
الإمام من الله
يا شباب يا شباب خمس أحداث ضربة واحدة خمس أحداث ضربة واحدة الحمد لله رب العالمين
لن نسقط يوما راية
نختم نحن وياكم بنشيد الرحمة
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان.
The Israeli Prime Minister's moment of truth. The final report of the Vinograd Committee handed to him 1 hour before they went public with it. But in the end, the most withering criticism was laid at the door of Israel's military top brass.
We have also found a very grave shortcomings in the military leadership to take the necessary action. We came across failure and shortcomings in all actions of defending the domestic front. The decision adopted by the Israeli premier and the position adopted by the defense minister, there were substantial positions built on sound grounds with these officials.
The main weight of the criticism in the final report actually fell on the shoulders of the Israeli military. But the question everyone else is asking is, will the Prime Minister Ehud Olmert survive this final report? And the word from his office is that they're pretty optimistic. They think he will weather the media storm that's about to break around him.
The Defense Minister Ehud Barak now has the Prime Minister's future in his hands. If he leaves the coalition, it will force early elections. But the Labour Party he leads fear they would lose out to the main opposition Likud Party. It would also completely derail the attempts to keep the peace track going with the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas. David Chater, Al Jazeera, Jerusalem.